हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज लेक्चर विल बी ऑन सस्पेंशन थेरेपी। एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स शुड बी एबल टू नो अबाउट द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ सस्पेंशन थेरेपी, द एपरेटस फॉर सस्पेंशन थेरेपी, टाइप्स ऑफ सस्पेंशन, टेक्निक्स, एफेक्ट्स एंड यूसेस एंड टेक्निक्स फॉर द इंडिविजुअल जॉइंट्स। Starting with the principles, now it works on a principle of pendulum. What is pendulum? By definition, a simple pendulum is a heavy particle suspended by a weightless thread and free to move to and fro. When the pendulum is at rest, the thread or the rope is vertical, but if the particle or the weight is drawn to one side and then released, the pendulum will swing to and fro. One complete swing in each direction is called as oscillation, means from this point to this point is called as oscillation, and the extent of the swing to any one of side is from the vertical is, now this is the vertical point, means point to any of the end, this is amplitude. From this to left is the amplitude. A force is required to set the pendulum in motion, and then the oscillation will continue until it is brought to rest suddenly by an opposing force or progressively by the resistance of the air. The time taken for each oscillation is determined by the length of the pendulum and the acceleration due to gravity. Now this was the principle. Now talking about the apparatus, this is the apparatus. It was invented by late Mrs. Guther Smith, and the whole unit is known as suspension unit. Now by looking at the original dimension, from length to breadth to height, it's about 2 meter. Talking about the parts, there are different parts. One is the fixed point, then comes the supporting ropes, then comes the slings, wooden cleat, dog clip, S hook and storage trolley. Now in many colleges, due to the spaces required to keep the suspension unit, they have modified the suspension and made it portable. Starting with the fixed point, it is made up of stainless steel or plastic coated steel in the top and head and side, presents the 5 cm metal mesh and remaining side kept open. Here is the metal mesh, and you can see if it is consist of a small square each of 5 cm in length and breadth, and this is called as the fixed point. Now in many colleges we have only at the top we have the fixed point where we can use it. Supporting ropes, there are following 3 types of rope: single rope, double rope and the pulley rope. We'll see one by one, starting with the single rope. Single rope has a fixed point at one end by which it is hung up. This is the fixed point. The rope is tied at the S hook. The other end of the rope then passes through the one end of the wooden cleat. Now then there is a wooden cleat. There are holes in the wooden cleat. Now rope one tied on the S hook, it passes from the one hole, it goes through the wooden cleat and through the ring of the dog clip. Here is a dog clip attached to the sling, and then from the dog clip it again goes through the wooden cleat and where we tie the knot. Now this is single rope. We got the double rope, consists of 2 pulleys at the upper and the lower attachment. Now here you can see there is one pulley, there is a second pulley, so there is a mechanical advantage of lever to V-gate. Pulley rope, this has a dog clip attached at one end. Now here is a dog clip which then passes over the wheel of the pulley, goes from here and then again attached to the second ring of the sling. passes through the clit and second clip. Now slings, there are following four types of sling. One is the single sling, double sling, three ring sling and head sling. We'll see one by one, we'll see the slings. Single sling, made up of canvas bound with soft webbing and with D-ring at each end. This is a metal D-ring, one and second. So D-ring attached at the end. It consists of 68 centimeter in length and 17 centimeter in width, used for mainly supporting the smaller joints comparatively, that is the elbow and the knee, because its size is small, folded to support the wrist and the ankle. Now double sling, broad slings with D-rings at each end. Now you can see there are many D-rings used to support the larger body parts like the pelvis, like the thorax or the thigh together, especially together the knees are kept together. Now again the its length is 68 centimeter and width is 29 centimeter. 3D ring sling, 75 centimeter in length. Now the name, the 3D ring sling, because there are three rings, one to each of the end, and in between there is a adjustable another ring. So three D rings are there, used for supporting the wrist and the ankle region. So these were the slings. Now last is the head sling. This is a short split sling with its two half stitch together at an angle to create a central slit. This allows the head to rest supported at the back under the lower and upper part of the skull. Wooden cleat. It is made up of wood and is used for altering the rope. Now this is the wooden cleat. There are holes in the wooden cleat through which the ropes are passed. It has two or three holes for the rope passage. The rope itself holds the cleat by friction resistance. Now whenever you want to adjust the length of the rope, you keep the wooden clip horizontal, and when you want to fix the rope at particular point, you kept it inclined position so it doesn't move. Dog clip or SO dog clip. Now you might have seen it in your kitchens also. This is like that only. Here it is movable part used to attach the supporting rope with mesh to attach the sling with the supporting rope so that the rope doesn't come out of the sling. S hook is in the shape of a S and it used for the fixed point. Storage trolley. In many of the colleges suspension unit this part is not available, so they have modified the plinth with drawers, and that is only used for the as a part of a storage. The storage of slings and ropes on the wall frame is done with S-shaped hooks. Types of the suspension, effects and uses. Now we are going to see. Now first of all, you have to understand why this is used. Now, whenever the patient is immobile or the patient strength is grade 0, then only we can give the passive movement. So what is continuous passive movement? Motion that is uninterrupted for extended period of time. It is usually applied by a mechanical device that moves a desired joint continuously through a controlled range of motion. Now assisted exercise comes under continuous passive movement, and suspension therapy is a form of a assisted exercise. Suspension therapy treatment or therapeutic exercise given to patient to increase the range of motion or to maintain the range of motion, to increase the muscle power and support the body parts by using the ropes and the sling to avoid the pressure source. Usually when the patient is immobile or in comatose for prolonged time. Now the aim of the suspension therapy is to increase the muscle strength and to improve the neuromuscular coordination types of suspension therapy, we'll see types of suspension therapy: axial suspension therapy, pendular and vertical suspension therapy. Now, the movement in axial suspension: a limb supported by ropes suspended from a point vertically above the joint to be moved is said to be an axial suspension. That is, the point of suspension is vertically above the axis of the movement. When the limb is relaxed, it will rest with the joint in the neutral position, and when movement is initiated, it will swing freely to either side of this resting position on a plane which is horizontal. It is the most common type. Joint is taken as point of suspension. Limb is supported by slings above the joint. Limb will move to both sides parallel to the floor. It uses for the relaxation of the muscle, maintain the muscle property, increases the blood circulation as movement is happening, and increase the venous and the lymphatic drainage. Pendular suspension. Now, we'll shift the point of axis to either medial or lateral side. That is the pendular suspension. What happens in pendular suspension? This type of suspension represents merely a lateral or medial displacement of the point of suspension from the position which it occupies in axial suspension. In these circumstances, the limb no longer rests in the neutral position of the joint but falls to a new resting position which lies toward the vertical plane containing the new point of suspension and the joint in question. Movement on either side of this resting position causes the center of gravity of the limb to rise, making possible pendular movement. Thus, in comparison with axial suspension, the muscle work required to produce movement away from the resting position is increased, but none is required for the return movement. The effect of this type of suspension upon movement from the resting position is similar to that of the inclined re-education board, which supports the limb during movement up the incline, but differs from it in that in pendular suspension, friction is virtually eliminated. Now, point of suspension should be shifted away from the joint of axis, and if you want to assist the movement, then you shift the point of axis in the direction of the movement. Example: pendular suspension, point of suspension should be shifted away from the joint axis. Movement usually takes place against, not against the gravity, but in gravity eliminating plane. Muscles will be getting resistance while movement if the axis is shifted opposite to that movement. Now, whenever you want to assist the movement, then if shoulder flexor, you want to assist the shoulder flexor, then you shift the point of axis anterior to the shoulder, that is in the direction of the shoulder flexor. And if you want to resist the shoulder flexor, then you shift the point posterior to the shoulder joint. Uses is to increase the muscle strength and to increase the muscle endurance. Vertical suspension, it is just for the support. The center of gravity of the body part or the body is taken at the point of suspension, used to provide support to the body part of the patient. Now, the uses will be the relaxation, prevent the pressure sore, and support. Advantages: it reduces the burden of the therapist, because to do the passive movement of a quadriplegic patient, what you have to move the upper limb, lower limb, and if you are just going through all the wards, for a therapist to move all the patient's upper limb, lower extremity is very difficult, because can cause a back pain. So eventually it reduces the burden of the therapist, easy to lift the limb, and active movement can be performed easily with minimum friction. Now, the disadvantages is that it requires a lot of space. Then patient has to move from the bed or from the wheelchair to the plinth of the suspension. If some resistance to the muscle work is required, the whole fixed point is moved away from the muscle which require assistance. On effort, the limb will now rise into abduction, brought about by isotonic shortening of the abductor, resistance being offered by gravity. slow lowering into the resistance portion is controlled by isotonic lengthening of the abductors. Now techniques for the individual joint. Now you will see for practical purposes in university examination we only keep certain joints and certain movements, like in upper limb for shoulder we give the cases. It is usually a short case, so for shoulder flexion extension and abduction adduction. For elbow, flexion extension. Similarly, lower limb, hip, abduction adduction and flexion extension. For knee, flexion extension. For shoulder joint, flexion extension. The position of the patient will be in sideline position. Point of suspension will be the shoulder joint. Two sling, one sling supporting the elbow joint and 3D ring sling supporting the wrist and the hand. Now, if you have been asked to show the abduction and adduction of the shoulder joint, then the position will be the quadrant position. Means for right shoulder joint, then the pillow is placed on the below the left shoulder joint. So you can see the movement taking place will be the abduction and adduction. So this will be the quadrant position. The point of suspension remains the shoulder joint, and sling will be supporting, one sling supporting the elbow joint, 3D ring sling supporting the wrist and the hand. For elbow joint suspension, flexion and extension, two positions are there. One is the sideline position. In sideline position, point of suspension will be the elbow joint, one 3D ring sling supporting the wrist and the hand. Now in sitting position, one vertical suspension will be required to support the humerus, to support the arm. So vertical suspension will be at the place of the mid shaft of the humerus, one sling 3D ring sling supporting the wrist and the hand, but the point of suspension for 3D ring sling will be the elbow joint. For hip flexion extension, the patient position is side lying. The point of suspension will remain the hip joint. The sling will be the one sling supporting the knee joint and 3D ring sling supporting the ankle and foot. For hip abduction and adduction, the patient will be in supine lying position, but the contralateral leg will be abducted so that the abduction and adduction movement will be completed. So point of suspension will remain the hip joint, one sling supporting the knee joint, 3D ring sling supporting the ankle and the foot. Knee flexion extension, the position can be position will be side lying position. Again, point of suspension will be the knee joint. Either you can place a pillow between the two thighs, and then only one 3D ring sling will be used to support the ankle and the foot. And if you are not using the pillow, then vertical suspension can be used, where it will be placed at the mid one sling vertical suspension supporting the mid shaft of the femur, that is mid of the thigh, and point of suspension will be the knee joint, and only one 3D ring sling can be used to support the ankle and the foot. Thank you.